The bones say nothing. Do you have feelings for the child? The bones have spoken. That's from a great scene in the 1988 movie Willow. The village wizard consulted the bones to figure out what to do with the child found by the main character, Willow. After casting them for a message from the gods on what should be done with the child, the wizard whispered his comment and question to Willow. Getting a nod saying yes, the wizard then shouted out for the villagers, "The bones have spoken!" There was no magic or divine revelation in the bones, but it was easier for the wizard to manipulate the people with a lie than the truth. What makes it such a great scene is that it accurately portrayed real life. People lie to manipulate others. When Israel was entering the Promised Land, God said they were not to follow anyone claiming a vision that pointed to the worship of other gods, even if they performed a sign or miracle that came to pass. Deuteronomy 13 verses 1 through 3. Any such message was a lie because it was a violation of the first commandment to not have any other God besides Jehovah. Deuteronomy 5 verse 7. That law was based on two fundamental truths. There is no God besides Jehovah. Deuteronomy 4 verse 35. And truth is his nature. Numbers 23 verse 19. Because he is truth, every word from his mouth is truth that must be believed and obeyed. God takes his word so seriously that he ordered Israel to execute any such false prophet, Deuteronomy 13 verse 5, even if he was family, Deuteronomy 13 verses 6 through 10. Before you say that was harsh or cruel, remember that lies lead to domination, destruction, and death. Look at what happened because of Satan's lies in the Garden of Eden in Genesis chapter 3. Fortunately for us, Jesus came as the revelation of absolute truth and through his death on the cross freed us from the bondage of sin. Romans 6 verses 1 through 11. The bones say nothing, but an empty tomb shouts the truth. Jesus is alive and will save us. Are we listening? Come back tomorrow for another Morning Minutes in the Bible. Until then, this is James McClenney hoping you have a great day.